Welcome to part two of our Gears of War Lancer prop build that we're making. In this video, we're going to work on putting the barrel in, adding some layers, some detail, and by the end of this video, you'll have something that looks like this. So let's get on the next step with this build, and we're going to be that much closer to finishing up. Okay, our pieces are sanded and moved to the side. Now comes the more laborious part of transferring all this information onto our template. I'm going to do it in sections. I'm going to start with this section here. I'm just going to remove the whole handguard. And with that removed, I can put this back in place. And make that line. Now everything I'm doing, you have to do to the other side as well. I'm not going to show that every single time because that'll get pretty old after a while. So now that we've got where it's going to sit, I'm going to break this down into more sections. I'm going to take this back piece off here. Trace that missing spot. Cut that piece out. Trace it. And go further down with that. Just for simplicity's sake, you don't have to get all these little details, but it's up to you. If you want more detail, it just takes a little more time. I'm just going to continue breaking this down and marking off the spots. It's worth noting that you can take some of these shapes and draw them on by hand if you wish. So you can use the bigger pieces as the main part and add in the rest. To show you what I mean, I'm going to remove this big chunk of the handle. Put this back. Trace that on. Then, I know there's a straight line here. And then along the bottom, I can just hand draw the bottom piece, looking at the template. And I also know there are straight lines going across here. The problem with doing it by hand is you run the risk of not having very good straight lines. Then you just continue breaking down the template piece by piece, transferring all those details on. Like I said, you could do it all by hand if you wish. But it's nice to have the template handy and use that to put your lines on. Okay, I've got the majority of the detail on. I left a couple of the smaller pieces off just because that's my preference. But I wanted to point out in areas such as here, when you get to this beveled edge, make sure you carry that down along that edge because we want that to also be scored. Same with this piece on both sides and with the grip. Extend it further into here. So any place that you have where it wraps around a little bit, you may want to go ahead and extend that out. And I think that's pretty much it. So before we start scoring everything and doing more with this, we're going to work on the stock of the gun. So I'm going to go ahead and set this to the side and we'll get on the stock. To do the stock, do an entire template of the left and right side. And now we're going to break the template down a little further. We're going to split it like this. And then we're also going to split this section apart. So your template should look like this, split apart. We'll want two of these, a left and right side. And it's going to be beveled along this dotted line. You can cut that out to mark your bevel, or you can eyeball it. I'm going to put that back on and trace that bevel line. Flip it over for the other side. Using a straight edge of some sort, I'm just going to mark because I want to bevel the bottom part of this. I'm just going to go ahead and mark it. I'm going to bevel it. Got the shapes cut out. I need to also put the detail lines in here. Okay, we have our details on here. Now we need to work on this. The bottom edge of these is going to be beveled. So I'm just going to take a sharp knife. And of course, continue to sand to make things look nice. And now we're going to cut out this inner line on both of these. Now we have these. Now what I'm going to do with these is I'm going to make them half the thickness, just like we did the other pieces. I'm just going to slice down the center to make this thinner. This will add an extra layer of depth. Okay, these parts are ready. I'm going to plug in the hot glue gun. While the hot glue gun is heating up, I know these pieces are going to stick together. So I'm going to go ahead and knock this shiny surface off the back with my rotary tool so they'll glue together better. They are sanded and we're ready to go ahead and put these pieces on. These are going to sit right above this line, or right on the line. Right on that second line on the bottom, just like that. And this piece will get glued just like that. Now I could use barge rubber cement here if I wanted, just for simplicity's sake, I want to use hot glue. I should have sanded this a little bit too, but we're going to skip out on that because these are pretty light. Shouldn't require a whole lot. Won't support a lot of weight, so hot glue should be able to hold this just fine. You want to not use so much hot glue that it's going to drip out everywhere, because hot glue is very difficult to clean after the fact. This one's going to sit just like that. Knowing that, I'm just going to put a small bead. Actually, I'll go ahead and put it on here. I was going to put it on the foam, but can't really control it as well. Just enough to make sure everything sticks where it needs to go, without making too big of a mess with the hot glue. Okay. And there we go with these pieces. Now these pieces are going to sandwich together like this. And again, there's going to be a little bit of use with it. It's going to be up against your shoulder, and these are really display props, but they're good for cosplay too. But just to make it a little more rigid, I may put something in the middle. So I'm going to look around and see if there's something I can put in here to make it a little sturdier. I found a good old paint stick. These are great to pick up at your local hardware store that sells paint. They usually give them to you for free. They're great for making sanding sticks, but they're also great for other random things you're going to use. You can use them for. I've scored two lines, one down the center and one this way, so they'll be the right size. And since it's scored, you can pretty much just break it off. I can sink it in there if you will. Again, this just adds a little more sturdiness to the piece. These are going right down there. Put that in place while I'm getting a new glue stick. And now two layers of barge rubber cement so we can stick these together and we can move forward. Of course, you can use hot glue as well. I just like barge because when I'm doing my finishing work, I don't have all that extra hot glue hanging out over the edges, which is more difficult to clean, believe it or not, or to sand away than barge rubber cement. If I can. Work my way around. The next piece we're going to work on is the trigger guard. It looks just like this. We cut that off at the very beginning. I'm going to trace this twice. We're going to trace the trigger one time, and we're going to cut off the back part where the foam is textured. There's the trigger. And we're just going to slice a thin layer of this off. Sand it smooth. And the bottom trigger will be done. That trigger guard will go right here. Now all is coming together. We need a trigger here, and we need to score all this detail, add a barrel, and we are done until we paint. So let's move on to the next step. The next step of building the body is preparing the chain rail. with this template, you're going to trace it twice. Once on the left, flip over, and once on the right. We're going to have two layers that sandwich together. And then to add in a layer of depth, we're going to remove this section. And trace that twice. Once for the left side, once for the right side. And once you're done with that, you can rake this down further and add that detail onto your templates. I'm sorry, onto your foam. I'd wait till you cut them out, but it's really up to you. It's transferring the things over to the from the template over to the foam, and I decided I'm going to change it up a little bit just because cutting these shapes can be a little difficult if you want them to look nice. So what I've done is I've used some piping. I've covered this in a video called Clean Circles and Holes that's also on the channel. And basically it's just a copper pipe that you sharpen, and you can use that to cut into the top of the foam. I have different thicknesses, and I'm able to make perfect circles into the foam. A little tiny one. So I've replaced what's on the template with my own design. And that's the beauty of stuff like this. Unless you're going for a 100% accurate representation, you can experiment and try new things like this. Got both of these sitting with the glue. It's almost dry, so we're going to put those together. And this will attach right on top like that. And it's stuck to my hand now. Okay, I've got the majority of the detail sanding done on here, and I've got these pieces done. So these pieces are just going to sit right here. I also added another hole here with my metal pipe just to add something different. So I'm just going to attach these with hot glue. I'm gonna let that cool off. So here is the chain rail section of the gun. The next part is probably the most nerve-wracking. We've got to go over all of this detail that we put in with a razor knife. I've also added a couple spots here to compensate for the shapes that were there that I don't want to cut out. Again, I'm just using sharpened pipes. These are copper pipes. And I'm just finding spots that I want to put it in there, twisting it till it cuts through that top layer. I want to make sure it cuts through, or it'll just basically, the heat will make the shape pop right back out. So if you don't cut through that skin, it won't stay. So now we're going to move on to a sharp X-Acto knife. Keep a sharpener handy. Want this to cut cleanly, and we're just going to start tracing all of these spots. It's important to make sure you don't overshoot your cuts too much, because every little overshoot will show up. By overshoot, I mean if you are making this cut right here and you go beyond this line, when you heat this up, there will be a cut there that you will see that won't look like it's part of the pattern. So stop when you get to the edge and make sure you're making a good clean cut. Cuts on these curves, I am bringing that cut around as well. Cutting and going down.
opening, going down.
Now this is a pretty laborious thing to do, so I'm not going to make you watch the whole thing. Just take your time, go slow, make sure your knife is sharp, or switch knives as you go, and continue until you've got majority, actually all of the detail put in. I think I might have missed some, but just to kind of get an idea, I'm going to go ahead and hit this with a hot air gun. I was contemplating on putting three dots here to compensate for these three things, which I think I'll just go ahead and do. It's a whole lot easier to do that than it is to cut that shape out. Okay, it appears I got everything. I didn't go over this because there's going to be a piece here. There's going to be a piece here, and a piece here. So I left those. Looks like the only piece I missed is right there. That did not open up. That's an easy fix. And now is the opportunity to look for places where your connections didn't go all the way through. Right here you can see there's a skin that needs to be cut to make that line full. So I'm going to go through and look for things like that. Snip those little edges, reheat it, and then we'll move on to the other side. This side has all the detail in it now. I've also gone ahead and did the detail work for the rail that will sit here, as well as the stock that'll be in the back. It's time to start bringing this all together. Don't forget, on your extra pieces, you have some detail you'll have to score in and heat up as well. And we're going to add this extra layer of dimension with these different pieces. And we're just simply going to hot glue them into place. Since we cut these at different thicknesses, they're going to be different thicknesses, which makes them stand out a little differently. They're not just one layer. It's a couple extra layers, and it really brings out the realism of the weapon having like a button that goes beyond this rail, that goes beyond the basic shape. So that's why we cut them that way. I'm trying to use enough hot glue to adhere it, but not so much that it's going to get everywhere. The less we have to clean up later, the better we are. Now we have two more sections here. Get a wide shot. Two more sections here. Section here and one here. But looking at the picture, there's LEDs that light up here, here, and here. If you wanted to, you could go through and set up a way to put in some LEDs. We're not going to go into that in this build. Maybe in a future build, we'll add those, but it's just a neat little thing you can add to really bring your gun to life. Sorry, I wobbled the camera. So there's one side of it with a little more dimension. Really starts to bring it to life. I'm going to flip it over and continue that on the other side. Both sides are done with the three-dimensional pieces. We've kept it pretty clean. We don't have a lot of glue, so that'll make the finishing a whole lot easier. We are going to now attach the rail. The rail will go right here. So we're going to start by doing this piece, and then we'll come back and do the other pieces. Make sure you line it up pretty good. Once it's lined up, make sure you hold it in the place while that glue dries. I want to make sure this is a good connection before we move on. I can add a little more down here and work my way around, but I want to make sure this is good and solid. Feels good. I'm again, check and make sure it's nice and straight. Hold it in place while it dries. Now we're going to attach the last little bit, which is this much more bendy section. Lift that for last. Last thing is to put a dab of glue back here and put that right into place. A glob of glue on there. Try to get that into place. Trigger guard will go right here. Should fit in nice and snug. Spot of glue. Okay, we're going to work on a little bit more detail work, which will be the sights and things like that on the top of the gun. I've lost my piece of the template that looks like this, so I just made a new one. You should have one. If not, just make this shape. It doesn't have to be perfect. It's just going to sit on top of the gun. So we need two of these at full thickness. I believe all these will be full thickness. Just one. And this is going to be half thickness, so I'm just going to go ahead and mark that. These are going to be full. And then we need this piece. Go ahead and trace the entire rectangle shape. Mark the split. We want to separate that into two pieces. And then we're going to cut out this little piece in the center. And trace one of those. I'm going to go through and cut this down the center, splitting it in half. And this is going to go between this, like that. I'm going to have these two sections that are going to go together like this. I will sand them to make them a little more flush in just a moment after I glue them. But while I have them down, I'm going to go ahead and mark the detail in them. Okay, I've heated these up to get the detail in them. I am now just going to hot glue them together. I'm going to sand them flush so it looks like one continuous piece and I get rid of any overhang or discrepancies like this. And while that is drying, move on to the next piece, which is the one we split that had the one in the center. I went ahead and put some lines in it, just scored some lines in it and heated it up just to make it look a little different. And this is the piece with the detail and the 45 that we made. So currently we have these sections to add to our weapon. The first piece, which will act as our sight, will go on like this, right in the center, just above where these two three-dimensional pieces connect. So if you could center that, you get a good idea of where to put it. Next piece, which is the 45 degree bevel and the square inside of it, it's going to go just in this direction. And it's going to go right behind this one with a small gap in between. The last section, which is this, which could probably use a little cleanup before I attach it, will go on right in front, right here. I'm going to cut this about 2/3, and this is going to do two things. It's going to thin these out, and it's also going to remove this texture side, which we don't want to be the backside of our blade. I'm sorry, of our teeth. All right, we are ready with the teeth. I decided just to shape them a little bit more like this. And I've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 still. And we're just going to put them on the rail, going up like this, and one up at the top that's going in. We're gonna start with that one because I already put a little bevel on that one, a little shape, so it'll fit on that circle a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and stick that bad boy right in the center. To attach the stock, we just first want to make sure that it's going to fit good and it looks like our cuts were good because this is pretty flush. We're just going to add a generous amount of glue between the two areas. Make sure you give this long enough to really sit up. And we're going to try to support this with some quick seal in just a minute. Just to give this an extra layer of sturdiness, I'm going to use some Quick Seal from DAP. I use this all the time. It's kitchen and bath adhesive caulk. And I use it to fill in areas, really to smooth things out. But it also works kind of as an extra layer of adhesion between these two parts. And this is probably going to get the most wear and tear. So I'm just going to take a small bead of it. Put it around the whole thing. And I'm also going to do that between the trigger guard. I'm going to do it along the rail here too. Now it doesn't look pretty yet. It may not actually look pretty at all when we're done, but it's all with the amount of effort you're willing to put in. So now we've got it in those areas. I think I'm going to put it around this too. I want this to be a smoother transition. Now what you need to work with this is this. You need a finger. We're basically just take a finger and we're going to use it to push that down into the cracks pretty well. So I've got some hot glue dangling in there. Using our finger to really fill those gaps in. We're going to continue that process around the trigger guard. If you remove a big glob like that, just wipe it off and go back and smooth it again. Bring in some detail. Okay, and now that we've got it roughed in, we're going to go over it with a wet finger. We're going to smooth it out, and then we're going to give it time to dry, and we'll be done with this part. I'm just going to squirt some water right here on the cleaner's part of the table. Use a cup, whatever you got. I don't have a cup. And you can just kind of smooth it out a little bit using a wet finger. This stuff is not very sandable, that's why we're doing this section or this step with sand, with using our finger to smooth it down as much as possible. So don't skip this step. Okay, so that will fill in that gap pretty well as it dries. And we can work more on it after that. So we're gonna give this time to dry after I do this side, and then we will come right back to it. Now is the time to start making some, or putting on some accessories. It's really up to you. I went ahead and made a front sight inspired by one of the images, which is just an old cap that I cut. I think it was a cap from a super glue container. Added a little piece of foam there. It's kind of like a riser. and I used a little bit of the DAP caulk that I put along here just to kind of smooth this out a little bit. And once I did put it on there and smoothed it out, I used a wet finger to make it even smoother. And I've also taken some googly eyes to use as bolts, so it looks like there's bolts in here. It adds another dimension of texture to the piece. So I got a bolt here, down here, one at the bottom of the mag, and so on and so forth. It's really up to you how you want to do it. I'm just adding some different embellishments that I personally like. You can use this as a reference if you like, but it's really up to you. And I also went ahead and started cutting out the hole for where the barrel's going to be. The barrel is a small piece of PVC pipe, and this is going to be stuck into this and hot glued into place. I'm going with about 1 foot of length, so I'm going to cut this part off, and a couple inches of it will go down into the gun itself, and I'm going to put a couple lines, a couple little pieces of foam as an embellishment that I'll show you as we go. I also added a little clip here that I found that will work for a flashlight. A lot of these weapons have flashlights that are attached to them, so this allows me to slide this on and off. This is something I had laying around. I have no idea what that went to, but it worked perfectly once I cut this lip down a little bit and made it fit. So now I can slide a light on and off to really add. You could use Velcro. Use whatever you want. I've gone ahead and designed the barrel. Just using the reference image, I used a small piece of craft foam here and put two little straps. The total length that I decided to go with is about 6.5 inches, knowing that about an inch of it will be in the gun, leaving 5 3/4 or 6 inches sticking out. So it'll look like this. So now all I'm going to do is fill this void full of hot glue, insert this in, and go from there. Probably add a little extra of the DAP around it just to make sure it helps kind of hold it in place. And I found this little tube to a super glue bottle that I'll put on top just as a little extra accent. So I'm going to get those in place. And again, you can't be afraid to experiment and try new things. One of the things that comes with my super glue bottles are these little plastic rings that go in the neck right here. You have to take the whole top off, remove this, and then when you put it back on, it pierces that foil to make this flow. So I've been keeping these little things, and I just realized they're almost a perfect fit for these little nodules up here in the front. So if I put those there with some glue, it'll just give it another element of depth that was not there before. So I think I'll go ahead and do that. I have enough to put three on each side. All right, we are at the point where we are ready to move on. I've done all the detail work that I think was necessary. I've added some rings here, a slide that I found that I cut a flashlight to fit into, so I can have a flashlight attached to the front. I've done all the detail work that I can pretty much do. I've added the barrel, put a little slice in it like that, much like the picture. Added a couple thin pieces of foam. Added this little doohickey, which is actually just a glue cap. I found this, which is a lid from my daughter's easy to open applesauce packs. And I put that right there. Kind of looks like a dial. So, I think I'm about ready to go ahead and put some plaster dip on this. If I've missed anything along the way, I apologize, but you can pretty much see everything I've done and do it your own way from here. And that's it for part two of the Gears of War Lancer build. You should have a pretty much a full gun like this, except it should be flat black and covered in plasti dip. So in the next one, we're going to paint it a little bit more. The paint is what really makes these things come to life and look a lot more realistic. Now that we've got the barrel and the layers and everything on it, we're just going to add the paint and really bring this thing to life. Shit.